of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
Hello everyone, this is Carrie. How are you guys doing? I wanted to do a inside tour of my new camper. It's a mess right now because we're in the middle of our weekend getaway with the boys for the first time, and it's been a mess, and the kids keep going in and making more of a mess and laying in their beds, and we've been laying in our beds just relaxing and cooling off because it is kind of hot this weekend for the first time for spring 2018. And sorry, I have no makeup on. I'm getting ready to go to the shower house, as a matter of fact, and take a shower for the first time in 2 days. So let me do the tour of what we have, and I'll talk at the end of the video. Bye. Walking in to the camper, and this is me and my husband's bed. Like I said, not made, but we got plenty of closet space. This is his side right here, closet space. We've got a bunch of cabinets up here with these tubs that I have gotten. I have yet to put anything in any of those. My side is the exact same thing. Two tubs and my side of the closet. Family sign that hung up on the wall. And our Explore sign. I got this at Walmart for like $4. It's great. It's really cute. Hung everything up with command hooks. I have been having a problem hanging things up with the command hooks, and I've tried Velcro. Also, still has not worked. But here's another view of our bed. It's a queen size bed, which is very comfortable. We may upgrade to a new mattress eventually. And at the end of the bed, I'm back by the front door again. Here is our table. Again, not very pretty because this stuff that's sitting on the table right here is to go underneath the camper. Don't even know why we have it out, but we have yet to put it away. It sleeps. This sits, all five of us, very comfortably. That's cool. Yeah. And then we have the kitchen area with our stove, which we have not used yet, and our stove top, which we have. My husband has to drink coffee like 4 times a day. Comes with a microwave. Cabinet up above is where we're keeping all of our bowls and plates and stuff. And as you can tell, I tried to hang that little shelf there with the command hooks. Did not work. They're falling off, so I gotta come up with another solution. I do have one of those baskets. Not baskets. I have one of those shelves that you put over a basket, maybe, and then I can put my bowls on top of that, but I almost have to find another basket to keep those in. We got the fire extinguisher and the radio there right by the front door, and we have silverware, utensils, knives in that first drawer. Second drawer, I have these little bottle tops so we can all know whose bottle's who with what color, some matches back there, and aluminum foil and Ziploc bags, plastic wrap. Down here in this little dollar store bin, I got all my pots and pans for baking. There's my muffin pan. In this cabinet under the sink, we have a great big huge thing of shortening, some trash bags, some extra coffee filters, and that's where I put my Keurig when it's not in use. And a little dish pan from the Dollar Tree full of my pots and pans. I will probably figure out a way of hanging up my lids using command hooks if I can get my command hooks to here to work. I got my Instapot. It's sideways under there because it's real narrow, and my strainer, but it works.
underneath our table. There is some storage, not on this side, but there is on this side, and I have some plastic bowls under there for different things. This is our refrigerator, fully stocked for the weekend. And this is our freezer, which only has some sausages and some two ice cream sandwiches left. Now, this used to look like this on the freezer, and it fell this weekend. I don't know why, but we will take it back to the RV park and we will have them fix that. More Dollar Tree bins here. Back here is chips. This is my pantry. Cereal, breakfast foods right there. More pantry space. That's one thing I liked about this camper, is it had plenty of places. I got my drink stuff and my snack stuff here. My canned goods here. Some sides. And then in this last one, I've got spices, baking, and then paper plates and all my paper goods there. Okay, I'm going to back that up again. So there's the fridge and the pantry. And then going towards the boys' bedroom part of the camper, I've got one bed, two beds, and three beds for all three of the kids. And there's the cabinet here where I've got their clothes in each thing there. Underwear, pajamas for Garrison on the top, Peyton, and Cameron. Of course, they've got all their shoes in my way here. I'm trying to do a video. In this bottom one, I've got some games. I had more games in there. And coloring stuff and cards for the kids to play with. I may put some more games somewhere. But for right now, Peyton's sleeping perfectly fine with those games back there in the corner of his bed. This is Cameron's. Of course, none of these beds are made, but they've been played in. Maybe I'll get a picture of them later to add to this video of them in each of their bunks. Garrison really does not fit up there, but he may switch sometime with Peyton, because here, as you can see, he's got way much more headroom, so we may do that. Bathroom is behind me, and I got this little sticker from the Dollar Tree. Here's my bathroom. When my husband hooked up the water last night for the first time, the boys, we have learned our lesson to check the faucet on the sink before hooking up the water, because it flooded the whole bathroom. But then there's the bathroom. It's a very tight squeeze there. There's a shower curtain. I bought that shower curtain that did not come with the key. I had some towels hanging up there, of course, with command hooks, and wasn't working. So again, the journey up, and just wanted to keep our camper very, very simple. It has everything we need. Like I said, we will get that fixed. Here's an overall view. So everyone, I'm sorry that that wasn't a very good tour, and sorry that I look exhausted, and that we are just in the middle of our camping experience for the first time, just trying everything out on our new camper, and it's been kind of a rough day today. You know, when you get a bunch of people in a small space, we all argue and fight. And we're hot and we're tired and you know, we're just beginning with this, but hopefully things will get smoother the more and more we camp and the more and more we are together. I'm hoping that we can all get along. When we had the little flood last night, it kind of upset everybody. We did not get our dinner the way we wanted to on a campfire last night. The boys weren't really interested in fishing as much as Jared was, and so he went fishing by himself this morning, and I don't think he was too happy about that because he had big expectations about fishing with the kids. They did do a little fishing, but it just wasn't what Jared was expecting. And some of the things, you know, you plan on putting into the camper when you're first setting things up, and when the command hooks don't stick to the wall and everything falls off, and when people are in your way when you're trying to cook and you don't have things that you were supposed to bring and communication just isn't working out, it gets kind of frustrating. So anyways, that's it for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. Like and subscribe. Leave a comment if you have any suggestions. Bye.